Hello, my name is Danielle from journeyofabrave.com and I am passionate about people's stories. I interviewed Lexing Sang from Art Lexing and I find this story very, very interesting because for me, fashion is a lot more about art than it is about clothes because it's all about a visual culture that you develop with time and that's what creates your style. So I think this is a vision that she shares with me and her whole story on how she has seen the whole art scene in Miami develop is amazing. So I hope you enjoy it. And this is part of a project that I did with GoDaddy where we interviewed entrepreneurs through the city. And I took it a step further, creating video journeys for you. Beautiful gallery located on Ironside here in Miami, in this area that not many people know of. And this is Lexing Sang behind
this. Hello, welcome to the gallery.
Special space.
Thank you, Danny.
Thank you for being here. So tell me a little bit about you. How did your journey in the art world begin?
It's a long story, but I'm always very interested in art. I had art history as a minor in college. And I opened my gallery in 2010, end of 2010 in Miami. Before that, I was an art consulting for clients who were collecting contemporary Chinese art. I worked primarily with a few young Chinese artists.
And how long ago was this? When did you decide to open your own space?
2010. Back then, I had a business partner, and she really encouraged me because I was 25 and she said, Lexing, you know all the artists and I know some wealthy people who could be collecting art, why don't I open a gallery in Miami? And there was no gallery who were sort of presenting contemporary Chinese art back then. And I said, why not? And that's what happened when you were young. You don't consider all the consequences and risks.
So you
did.
You had never sort of thought that a gallery would be a good idea until she mentioned it?
No, I always wanted to open a gallery, but I thought, because I went to business school and I thought maybe that would happen sort of later on when I'm more established, and because gallery is a very expensive business, I know, especially starting up. And I just never thought it would probably happen that early.
What about art inspires you so much?
I feel art is, I always tell people around me or my friends when we have a discussion, it's a food for the soul. We all need it. And it's something that would take us to either inspire us or give us this transcendent experience. And that's how I define good art too. It's some pieces that would take you to another space or time or experience.
I have to say, I really believe you're right. I feel the same way about art. But also these pieces in particular, yesterday was the opening at this gallery.
Yeah.
And just looking at these pieces, you get lost inside of them. Which is not a feeling that you usually get. Can you tell us more about the artist?
Definitely, yeah. So right now in the gallery, you can see this piece. And we're having a solo show for my Chinese artist Ye Hongxing, and she's known for making sticker collage, and maybe later we'll do some close up. Mm-hmm. But this piece is entirely done with little stickers that kids use, and when we were little, we all collected stickers. But then my artist transformed the material and did a giant, very sophisticated mosaic piece,
mm-hmm.
and it's her view on our modern world. So you see a different influence from different cultures and different religion symbol, pop culture elements. It's all mixed, and that's why this exhibition is named as Modern Utopia. It's a time that all cultures come together and the people of different backgrounds should be coming together. It's diversity that adds the beauty to our society.
Absolutely, it's about living, but I can absolutely get lost in these pieces.
Yeah, the more you look at, the more things you will see.
Exactly. Every day you see something different. And what have been some of the obstacles that you've encountered in having a gallery in Miami?
I think because now I'm looking back, gallery business is not, because we're selling a product that no one really needs. And it's definitely a difficult business. And especially at the beginning, when people don't know much about my artists and they don't know what sort of the gallery program is, and it's a trust relationship that I'm building with my clients, also with the community. People who believed in me and believed in my artists invested in the artists and the gallery, and then through all the years my artists have grown. It's all because of the trust that people had in us.
What is the best moment of your day?
What is the best moment of my day? Yesterday, last night was amazing. I'm really happy people all came out, even if
so many people.
Because people think of galleries as a very glamorous job, but I'm here to tell you the secret. Let's say I'm a professional mover, because there are a lot of logistics happening, and especially when you're dealing with international artists. The happiest moment for me yesterday was when everything actually came together. We didn't have lights in the space, and the pieces were coming, some from Mexico, some from China, and some were coming from Texas. And they all sort of arrived on time, which was a miracle. And then, so I was actually the happiest 2 hours before the opening, when I made sure that everything came through.
It arrived!
Yeah.
And what would be then your advice for someone starting in this same line of business?
My advice is to train your eyes, because if you want to work in arts, I would suggest you to travel and go see the best art, the masterpieces, and the best exhibitions, and in the best institutions, in person. And that's how you elevate your eyes.
Which are some of your favorite fairs right now? Because Lexing is traveling year-round.
My favorite fair, so we can talk about Zona Macro in Mexico City for
yes.
a minute, because Mexico City is really, really growing. Danny knows I'm in love with Mexico. Mm-hmm. And Zona Macro is a contemporary art fair that happens every February, and it brings international galleries as well as Mexican galleries together. Mm-hmm. And they showcase a variety of blue chip artists, but also up and coming artists from Mexico and beyond. I really love this fair, not only because they have a good selection of artworks, but they also have a great program around it, so you can go visit private collections. And Mexico City is so happy. There's so much to see and so much to do. I always have the best time.
It's booming right now, and I love to leave that fair, especially through your eyes and your
yes,
story.
Yeah. It's really a great week.
Mm-hmm. So in the end, how would you define success?
How would I define? I think it's it's very personal. I think for me is because my job is really to facilitate all my artists. So to see my artists succeed, for me, I probably have arrived, and I still have a long way to go. But so to see when my artists are making breakthroughs in their career and milestones, that to me is an achievement. But success is a very abstract, and personalized, I think it's, for me personally, it's to live a rich life, meaning have different experiences and meeting different people,
cultures. What do you think of the art scene in Miami right now?
The art scene in Miami, I would say, I was in Miami Beach. It's now more than 10 years and have completely transformed the city.
Mm-hmm.
And the art community is constantly growing. We're attracting a lot of galleries moving from north, and also artists are decamping to Miami because it's a great place to be. And it also connects with Latin America, a lot of great artists, but also collectors. So it's a really exciting time to be in Miami.
The city, and you saw it since the beginning. Almost.
Yeah.
That's very exciting. And so what about you? What's next for Art Lexing?
For my next show, I'm actually preparing a solo show for my Chinese photographer in Mexico City in September. I would like to participate in the gallery weekend.
What's the name of your photographer?
Quentin Shi, and he did a whole series of photos in China and also in Havana, in Cuba, and then in North Korea, because it's very interesting. As Chinese, we're all very interested in other communist regime,
yes.
per se. So the exhibition is going to be called A Communist Voyage, and putting together his three series of photos set in China Cuba and North Korea.
Wow. Thank you very much, Lexi.
Thank you, Danny.
Love our conversation.
Thank you so much.